Okay, in this video, we will study about the disorders of the kidney. First disorder is the edema. Okay, basically, what is edema? When more and more fluid is present in any tissue, more than the required, that tissue starts swelling, and this swelling is basically called as the edema. This edema is caused because of the high concentration of sodium ions in that tissue. And when the sodium ion concentration increases, the water retention also increases. That is, more and more water is reabsorbed in that tissue, and because of which the edema is caused. Second is diabetes insipidus. Diabetes insipidus is basically because, okay, deficiency of antidiuretic hormone. Antidiuretic hormone, we all know that it is a hormone that is basically produced by the hypothalamus, secreted by the posterior lobe of pituitary gland, and it acts on the kidneys for more and more water reabsorption. And when there is less or deficiency of antidiuretic hormone, water will not be reabsorbed. And when water is not reabsorbed, the water is lost from the urine, and this causes dehydration, and or that condition, okay, more and more water loss, so more and more urine is excreted by that individual. So that condition is called as diabetes insipidus. Next one is renal tubule acidiosis. What is renal tubule acidiosis? If any person is unable to produce adequate amount of hydrogen ions, what is going to happen with that person is that more and more bicarbonate ions, that is HCO3- bicarbonate ions, are lost from the urine. And that condition is called as a renal tubule acidiosis. Okay. The next condition is hypertension. Hypertension that is related with the synthesis of renin. Okay. When more renin is synthesized, more angiotensinogen gets converted into angiotensin 1, and angiotensin 1 gets converted into angiotensin 2. This is going to cause the hypertension, and it increases the blood pressure, and that hypertension is called as hypertension due to the renin. Next one is renal calculi. Renal calculi are basically the kidney stones which are formed. These kidney stones are basically formed of the salts like oxalates. Salts of oxalates, and these are the insoluble stones that are formed. Now, these stones are basically the stones of the oxalates. Next one are the, or the condition is called as nephritis. Now, what is basically nephritis? Inflammation of any part of the nephron is called as a nephritis. Now, in nephritis, there are two conditions. One condition is called as glomerulonephritis. Glomerulonephritis means where the glomerulus is going to get inflamed. Inflammation of the glomerulus, and the glomerulus is engorged with blood. It is filled with blood, and that condition is called as a glomerulonephritis. The another nephritis, which is called as the polynephritis. In case of the polynephritis, what happens is that the renal pelvis and the medullary region, it gets inflamed or it gets swollen. That condition is called as a polynephritis. The last one is a renal failure. Now, what happens in the renal failure is that the kidneys are going to stop the process of urine formation, or they are going to fail, as the name suggests, renal failure or the kidney failure, where the urine is not formed. We have studied what is oligonuria and anuria. In oligonuria, 250 ml of the urine is excreted throughout the day, and in anuria only 50 ml of the urine is excreted throughout the day. So that happens in renal failure. What is acute renal failure? Acute renal failure. Acute renal failure means suddenly, okay, both the kidneys are going to stop functioning. That condition is called as an acute renal failure. Now, what might be the conditions for renal failure? Okay, one is low blood volume. Second can be the renal calculi or the kidney stones. Third can be low blood volume, kidney stones. Third can be less cardiac output, infection of the kidneys, or there is damage in the renal tubules. All these conditions might lead to the renal failure. Or sometimes more and more consumption of anti-inflammatory drugs, okay, or more and more consumption of antibiotics, that also leads to the renal failure. So these are some of the causes which are caused which causes the renal failure. So there is low blood volume, kidney stones, cardiac output is less, that is the heart is pushing up less blood. So these are some of the conditions which are responsible for the renal failure. So these were some of the disorders of the kidney that we studied. In the next video, we will study about micturition and some another points that are related with the human excretory system.